Here we have with us senior forward Ben Stitz, senior goalkeeper Nick Christoffersen, head coach Brian Gill, and a 3-0 win over Rutgers this evening. They will advance and play at Syracuse Sunday at 2 p.m. Coach, we'll start with an opening statement from you on tonight.
Yeah, first I would congratulate Coach McKeldery and his group. I think they are a really good team and deserving of their success this year and winning a big championship for their program and their school. So a lot of respect for him as a person, as a coach, and know a lot of those players, and I think they are they were a really tough opponent for us coming into the first round. So I think with that being said, I was really happy with our guys. I thought that was in terms of tough times of the year and big moments for us, I thought we came out and played with a lot of energy. I thought we played with a lot of inspired moments in the game and got a lot of those right on both sides of the ball. Ben had probably one of the best performances in Penn history, there with two goals in an NCAA tournament game, and so much more to the game even than just the goals. And tremendous performance by our back four and the guy sitting on my other side here in goal. I thought his saves came at all the right times and kept us in the game, and to be able to get a shutout at home in an NCAA tournament game against the Big Ten champs is something that we're super happy with in our locker room, and as I say, it'd be one of those memorable results for us in our program's history. So I think we're delighted to be able to go up to Syracuse and face another really good opponent. So I think from our standpoint as a staff, though, we're super excited for our guys. They work really hard, and to get this reward is all the best for everyone in the program.
We'll begin with questions for student athletes, please.
Ben, that first goal, 65 seconds into the game, how important was that to kind of just give you guys ability to sit back and control the game, really, and be on the front for most of the game?
Yeah, I mean, it definitely calms the nerves a little bit once you can get ahead, especially early. And probably did a good job managing it from there. And, I think, being able to be relaxed and play our game through the first, 35, 40 minutes, it helped us. It really helped us. And then obviously found the second a little bit later on. So being able to have that two-goal cushion going into half and then being able to manage the game from there, it helped a lot.
How did it feel to score that goal?
I felt awesome. Yeah, I can't lie. I felt awesome. Especially the past couple of games I hadn't scored. I had a couple assists, but get back on the scoring run. So I felt good.
Nick, what allowed you guys to be so successful defensively, keeping to a clean sheet? What allowed your defense to be so successful?
Well, I think we really embrace everything about defending. I think we embrace big plays, big blocks, guys covering for each other. Plays that I think are recognized on a stat sheet, and I think that's what leads us to get results like we do today. And I think, like Coach said at halftime, I think some of our best offense comes from playing defense and just being in good shape. So we really embrace that. We embrace our identity, and I think that's what leads us to get results like tonight.
More for student athletes.
For Nick. So this is your third straight clean sheet, which is pretty amazing. In that time, how do you think, or through the season, how has been communicating with your defenders, creating that really solid back four in front of you? How much has that communication and relying on defenders helped you to kind of achieve really big saves in front of goal?
Well, I think as the season progressed, this group has just gotten tighter and better, and I think it really comes down to trust. They trust me behind them to make the plays they need. They trust me to cover them. And it's what allows us to not have confusing moments, bad moments as a back four that we kind of look back on. We just trust each other to make the plays. When balls aren't mine, I trust the guys in front of me to impact whether they're getting on it or whether they're the ones to make the plays. I trust those guys to make those plays. And of course, if it doesn't come off, I'm there to clean things up. So I think we really just embrace our identity. And we really buy into it, and I think that's what causes us to, get those clean sheets at the end of a season, which is big.
Even more for these student athletes. Ben, Nick, thank you.
Appreciate it.
Yeah, Coach, first off, congratulations. I wanted to ask about that first goal a little bit and how, as a coach, did your sort of, what were you telling your team and how you wanted to approach the game? Did that change at all, or did you sort of wanted to stay aggressive?
I mean, there's an adage in sport that goals change games. So, I mean, that, I think early goal puts us on the front foot. We can stay the aggressor in some ways because we know that they're going to be looking to respond to that and maybe takes them out of their groove a little. So, you know, from our perspective, always trying to play for those first goal moments, I think makes us no different than other teams out there. But, yeah, I mean, it definitely gave us a lot of confidence. I think before the goal got scored, we had a really good opportunity. Stas had a great opportunity. They got saved, well saved by their keeper. But then to be able to execute on that play was, you know, really big. And, you know, as we would think in our way, like anytime Ben Stitz is getting goals, it's going to be big for us just because he when he has his confidence going, he can be a difference maker player and, you know, one of the best in the country, in my opinion. So,
yeah. It seems like Rutgers came out very strong in the second half. How did you feel your team was sort of able to keep control of the game? And then ultimately, Ben obviously had that second goal, which I would say, you know, put the nail in the coffin. But
yeah, I mean, I think anytime you know, like, you're in two-goal leads are tough because there's enough cushion there for you to feel relaxed. But, you know, at any turn of the of play, they're back in it with a goal. And so I think from our perspective, players being able to kind of keep their focus in the right ways, you know, as Nick said, like just rely on each other and you know, withstand the stress tests of what a good team is going to throw at you, whether it be numbers or just getting their quality right. And Rutgers has a lot of quality in their front four and five players. And, you know, I think we knew that they were going to try to push some tempo. And, you know, at the end of the day, we were fortunate to be able to make the plays that we needed to keep the ball at the back of the net. And then, you know, when the defense broke down, I thought Nick made some terrific saves, and he's been really steady for us this year, making some saves at the most critical times. So.
Any more for Coach?
Yes. So, through the season, I think even before you mentioned that, like this group of players has been like really like tight, and like just the team up overall, like the locker room vibes are really good. And just like going away on those road trips together really like strengthened a lot of those bonds. At this point in the season, would you say like are there any particular names who maybe you don't really see on the score sheet that often that are just really strong presences in the locker room that you are just very like grateful to have in your team?
Oh yeah, ton of them. I think the team is filled with them. There's guys that are playing that don't maybe get on the stat sheet. Like an Aaron Messer or a Jacob Muchnick, who are really big for us. Nick Shimbino, who's been an outstanding performer for us on the field in a lot of ways, but also his leadership has been a real foundation for this group. And then I think there's guys that put in the work. Mateo Zazueta, who I think his personality is one of the keys to this group. I think it keeps us light at all the right times, and Michael Tiedijts and Michael Hughes have been just kind of coming into their own in all the right ways on the field. But, you know, I think you start to see their playing personalities and their competitiveness come out when we're on the field, and then off the field, they along with Mateo, do a great job of keeping us just level. And a lot of the young guys, I mean, all this whole freshman group has just been such a good group to work with. I think they're a fortunate group in that their first experience in college soccer is to be able to go to the second round of the NCAA tournament and win a conference championship. So my hopes are for those guys in the future as we continue to go, you know, through year two for them and then year three and year four eventually, that, you know, they're as good back to the younger players as older players have been to them.
Any more questions for Coach?
Yeah, quickly, Coach, just looking ahead to Syracuse, what are your quick expectations of that match in a few days?
I think Syracuse is one of the best teams in the country, if not the best team in the country. So we're going in there knowing that. We are looking at it as our greatest challenge and our next challenge. Or I should say it the reverse way. Our next challenge is our greatest challenge. And so, yeah, I think when you're playing in the NCAA tournament, which is a single elimination format, yeah, the beauty of it right now is that sometimes it's not always about, you know, the number one teams in the country or, you know, playing in the best conferences in the country. It's about the best team on the day. And so, you know, I think with us being able to understand our identity, as both these guys have said, and you have seniors playing at a really good level in our team, and it gives us a chance. And I think we'll be motivated, and I think what's nice about tonight, being able to get some goals, is some guys were able to get some rest too. So, yeah, I think our group will be up for it and motivated. I have no complaints about our fitness levels throughout the course of the season. So, yeah, I'm sure there are some tired guys in the locker room, but I think we'll travel well and give it our best chance and represent Penn as well as we can.
Any more questions for Coach?
Good. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.